Growing up, the way I thought about money was way different than the way I think about money now. I had to learn a lot of things the hard way, and just so you don't have to, I want to share with you what I learned about money in my 20s. And by the way, I'm halfway through my 20s, so I've got this adulting thing down pretty good. Someone even called me an old man the other day, so you know this is about to be legit and full of wisdom. So the first thing my 20s taught me about money is one of the harshest realities I've ever seen. Not that many adults know much about money. And it's kind of sad to think about because there's a bunch of adults out there who would otherwise be considered well off. But because there's such a lack of financial literacy across the entire world, that leads to a bunch of problems. These problems can skew our idea of success and happiness, and when that happens, we find people who are lost, unhappy, and unfulfilled. All because we're making decisions right now that will affect us for years to come, and most of those decisions are based off of someone else's opinion. You were probably given a specific path growing up. Go to school, graduate, get a job. Or if you were like me, go to school, graduate, further your education, graduate again, and then get a job. This path is handed out as if there's no other alternative, like this is the only chance you have of living a successful life. They even go as far as telling you which majors to go for and which ones to stay away from, and I'm sure you know exactly which majors I'm talking about, so I'm gonna do myself a favor and I'm not gonna mention any of them. That way I won't start a war in the comments. This advice comes from parents, guidance counselors at schools, teachers, neighbors, coaches, friends. And it's not like there's a ton of room for you to hear your own thoughts when you have all these voices in your ear telling you what you should be doing. They might even phrase it like this: see, what you need to be doing is this. No, bro, that's all wrong. Let me tell you from experience, most people in your life don't truly know what you need to do specifically to be successful, happy, or fulfilled. They normally just opt to tell you to go for the highest paying field without any regard for how much you actually like it. That's what I grew up seeing, and that's just a part of life, but at the same time, it's something that we have to get past if we really want to better ourselves. Because you're told to go for the nice title, the salary, or even a job that requires a specialized skill, all because of the job security and how much money you can potentially make doing that job. But how many people tell you how to properly use that money? How many people tell you if you don't want to be in a certain job or field forever, that you should be smart with your money, that you should save it and invest it in the skills that will free you from that job and take you far beyond where you are right now in your salary? How many people have conversations with you about the cost of living, now you should never let the amount of money you make get to your head? And most importantly, do you have anyone in your life telling you that you need to make more than one stream of income? If no one's talked to you about this stuff before, that proves my point. Most adults don't know much about money, how to hold on to it, investing, or how to build another stream of income. Most just know how to live a pretty comfortable life and get by. Trust me, I've seen this too many times. And if you're the type of person who wants to live a pretty good life, get by, live slightly above your means, and do slightly better than breaking even every month for the rest of your life, I think that's fine if that's what makes you happy. But I don't think it's fair to those who are going to follow what they've been shown their entire lives, and then when a pandemic hits, or if their job cuts their hours, they don't have a safety net to follow on and they don't know what to do. Or even worse, it's definitely not fair to those who aren't happy with the path they've chosen to go. And now they regret the fact that they listened to the unsolicited advice that everyone around them decided to give them at a young age. A lot of adults are lost themselves, but they don't always act like it though. And lost adults look like people you see every day. Your teachers, your guidance counselors, your family. I'm not making this up. I'm friends with a lot of my old teachers and guidance counselors on Facebook. And even some peers of mine who work with me, all of which are classified as successful people. But I've seen a lot of them write posts on Facebook talking about how lost they are and how they don't know what to do with their lives. And that hits different when you realize a lot of them have been giving you advice since you were a kid. You feel what I'm saying? And that's why we have a lot of the problems we see today, like the fact that living paycheck to paycheck is a normal thing. Pair living check to check with the fact that you don't like your job, you're not happy or fulfilled, and you have no other way of making money. Is that the place you want to be mentally? Of course not, bro, but that's the reality for a lot of the adults out here, and I've come into contact with hundreds of them in person. I've even come into contact with them in Zoom calls. I also get a bunch of comments on YouTube about it, DMs, and emails about this stuff, so that further proves my point. And honestly, this is why I created this channel in the first place. And here's another thing, you'll hear people say this a lot. I wish somebody told me about this. Well, if someone would have told me about this, things would be different. And here's my advice, man, because I personally hate hearing that. You're an adult, so you can't always wait on someone to tell you to do something all the time. Sometimes you have to understand that you have to educate yourself and really look into what you're about to get yourself into. For example, I've had a hobby that I've been very passionate about and very interested in for most of my life, and that's drumming. I drummed all throughout middle school, high school, and college. My instructor didn't show me everything. There's not enough time in the classroom to learn everything you need to know about drumming, so I had to spend time outside of class doing my own research. I studied famous drummers and found out what made them great. I went to drum clinics. I got coaching on how I could get better with reading music and playing the drums and having better form. I went to drumline camps. I didn't worry about learning everything in one day, so I learned little by little. And you're probably thinking, when it comes to money, Reggie, I don't know what I don't know. And that's true. But the same can be said about anything. So what you do is you look up basic skills that you already know of that you want to improve in. You can look up stuff like how to save money, which can lead to videos on how to budget. Budgeting can lead to frugal living videos, and before you know it, you'll be watching step-by-step tutorials on how to start a side hustle. And once you've watched enough videos on how to make more money, next thing you know, you'll be watching videos on how to invest in the stock market. That's literally the exact order it went for me. And that's my point. It just takes effort up front. No one ever sat me down and talked about the cost of living, how to invest, or how to start my own side hustle. I had to do those things on my own. And as an adult, we have to do that sometimes, and there's nothing wrong with that. We can't let our disadvantages act as excuses to stop us from learning and improving. Not everyone's going to have the same opportunities, and yes, most people are living paycheck to paycheck, just barely breaking even. But I'll also tell you that some of these people are working minimum wage jobs, and some of them are making six figures a year. And it all goes back to financial literacy and breaking out of the feeling of comfort. You've got to want more for yourself. Not everyone is going to grow up with the luxury of having parents, coaches, and mentors teaching them all about the ins and outs about money and investing. Not everyone's going to grow up getting everything handed to them. I sure didn't have that luxury, but that doesn't mean we should resent those who do. Because you best believe when I have kids, they're going to be extremely financially literate at a young age because life is too freaking short to be worried about some doggone finances. On the other side of all this, there's life. You know what I'm saying? So if you are living paycheck to paycheck, I actually have a whole video that shows you the play-by-play on how to turn that situation around. And the biggest reason I bring up the fact that most people live paycheck to paycheck is because when I first found out about that, I was genuinely surprised. I thought most adults were well established and made really good money and knew exactly what to do with it. But that wasn't the case, and that's actually what led to me making my video on the biggest money trap, which happens to be lifestyle creep. I grew up being a bougie dude, you know what I'm saying? Me, my siblings, and really my family as a whole, we have that expensive taste. And I don't think there's anything wrong with that, man. Like, I love to go out to eat, I like to have a good time, and I like to have nice things. But if you want all of that, in addition to your current lifestyle, you're going to have to plan for it. And on top of that, you got to put the work in to actually be able to do that. Because if you don't, that's what leads to bad spending habits, and that's what leads to living paycheck to paycheck. And of course, it's not the only way that happens. Sometimes we have things like unfortunate events and circumstances that are out of our control. But the problem I see most often is a lot of us just overdo it. And I did this myself when I first moved out and got my own place, but I learned from that and now I know better. I don't need to be out here paying an arm and a leg for rent just for extra space if I don't have to. That didn't cause me to live paycheck to paycheck, but that's more money I could have had in my pockets. Because let's be honest, living expenses are huge. But you know what your biggest expense is? Taxes. And that's what I mean when I say most of us overdo it, because when you think you're making $50,000, $60,000, $70,000 a year, you really aren't making that much money. You're getting taxed a lot. So the money left over after tax is what we should go by. Nobody told me that. But when rent's due on the first, when you have to eat, when you have a family to feed, the excuse of nobody told me that ain't gonna work, bro. In this life, you have two choices. You can either make money or make excuses. And I choose to make money. And this is where the video gets real interesting, because making money is a lot easier than we make it seem. Like I said before, getting a college degree, an associate's, or a trade isn't always the answer. As someone who excelled in school, one thing I realize is that it's not for everyone. I've even been urged and pushed to go to grad school, but I refuse to go because I don't think there's anything for me in grad school. Especially when I think about the goals I have for my life right now, it just doesn't add up. So when it comes to making more money, I think it should be something that you actually want to do and something that you enjoy doing. Of course, an easy way to make more money is by picking up overtime at work if your job offers it, or of course, picking up part-time work. But to me personally, that's not the first thing I would go to, because there's a bunch of other avenues you can go down to get extra money, and this takes a lot of time away from you. But at the same time, depending on your financial situation, this might be what you have to do to get ahead financially. But I want you to know, you can do a lot of stuff and monetize off of it on your own accord without having to answer to anyone else, where you can actually command a certain amount of pay. The days we had to put in a bunch of years of work up front, get an education, and pass a certain amount of tests in order to be successful, and only that, those days are gone. Because now we need more than just a job. We need more than just one stream of income. We need multiple streams of income. And I can't stress enough how important it is to have at least two. As the world continues to progress and as inflation continues to rise, we're going to need more streams of income. Right now, there's a gap between wages and inflation. Wages are starting to stagnate while inflation ain't stopping for nobody. So it's important to make sure money keeps flowing to you for stability of your lifestyle, or if nothing else, control over your life. The problem with that is most of us aren't willing to put in the work, the effort, or the time to make these things happen. Mostly because of fear, discouragement, and an overall lack of confidence. That's going to happen every time you better yourself. There's going to be an initial fear that sets in, and that fear is going to turn into a voice in your head that says, what if I'm wasting my time? What if I'm doing all this for nothing? And I know, because that's what happened to me as I was building this YouTube channel. Anything I've done in my life that's had an ambitious goal behind it, that thought was in the back of my mind. And if I ever told the wrong person about my goals or my ideas to make more streams of income, the other person almost always responded with silence and one of those looks like, y'all know what I'm talking about. One of those looks like, you know that ain't happening, right? Those doubtful looks that people closest to you give you for some reason. And that can lower your confidence. But all those problems exist because we think it's so difficult. You can do a lot of things to add value to people's lives and get paid for it. From babysitting to walking dogs, Uber driving, yard work, painting, clearing out garages. You can even market yourself online and teach people a skill that you have. That's what I did when I taught people how to play the drums, and I charged them over $30 an hour. I was doing something that added value and helped other people get what they want. You see kids with lemonade stands in the middle of the summer. That's giving people what they want, that refreshment. You see people selling hot dogs and hamburgers on the corner. It's not that complicated, and I made a whole video giving you the game on making more money. It's called Achieve Financial Freedom and Make More Money, and that video goes in depth on how to make more money, and it also tells you how to reinvest the money you make from what you're doing so you can continue to grow. This is what my 20s taught me about money. Most of us adults don't know much about money because we were misguided as kids, or because we decided to go down the path that we thought was right for us and woke up to a very rude awakening. That leads to a life of living paycheck to paycheck while also being somewhat comfortable. And sometimes it gets so comfortable to the point where you don't even want to improve your situation. That is, until something drastic happens and then you're looking about sick. And it's easy for us to get frustrated and say, my job doesn't pay enough. I have too many bills. I'm not skilled enough or educated enough to make good money. I'm in student loan debt. Nobody told me about this, so how was I supposed to know? I've got four words for you. Multiple streams of income. It's not easy, but it's a lot easier than we make it seem. You don't have to go out there and be desperate and do stuff that's less than dignifying to make this extra money. You just have to figure out what you're good at and how you want to monetize it. That's all you have to do. And I talk about it a lot on this channel, so check out my side hustle videos if you really do want to make extra money. Because it's not like I'm saying you need to go out there and make a living with your side hustle, but this can help you build a financial cushion and it can open doors to opportunities that you wouldn't have otherwise had. Like being able to invest in the stock market, saving more money than usual, getting stuff done around the house like redecorating or whatever it is that you want to do. Even going on vacation without having to worry about how much you're spending. This is what I took away and this is what my 20s taught me about money so far. I hope you got value from this video, and I hope I've opened your eyes to help you see that it's our decisions to do or not to do something that actually shapes our financial future. And just because someone acts like they have all the answers does not mean they have all the answers. I definitely don't have all the answers, which is exactly why I learn and grow every single day, and whatever I learn comes right back to you guys. Remember, always seek advice from someone who's made it to where you want to be. That will get you the results you've been looking for. Anyways, that's the video for today. Thank you so much for watching. My name is Reggie Bryant, and this channel is all about personal finance and personal growth so you can control you, control your finances, and control your life. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe if you like this video. I will see you in the next one. Stay cold.